'Cause I know that you feel me somehow. You're the closest to heaven that I'll ever be, and I don't wanna go home right now. And all I could taste is this moment, and all I can breathe is your life. Sooner or later it's over. I just don't want to miss you tonight. And I don't want the world to see me, 'cause I don't think that they'd understand. When everything's made to be broken, I just want you to know. Moment of truth in your lies, when everything feels like the movies. Yeah, you bleed just to know you're alive. And I don't want the world to see me, 'cause I don't think they'd understand. When everything's made to be broken, I just want you to know.
Renee, it is said that love is found where one least expects it. And to be honest, I never believed in something so cheesy, but it happened to me. One cozy night in New Brunswick, outside of a Wendy's. No, I wasn't trying to make a quick buck. It was shared between two individuals bewitched by one another, but found solace and warmth in an amazing David's triple. It wasn't just that fateful night. It was the love I felt through your actions each and every night thereafter. The love you shared through the good times and the bad. The love you shared with my mother and Mama, who I wish were here today. And the love you shared with the people closest to me. So I promise to love you and follow you to the ends of the ends of my outer space. I promise to be your Superman if you be my Wonder Woman. I promise to always make you laugh and smile when life doesn't seem so bright. Renee, I leave you with this. I thank my mother each and every day for telling me to marry you. And even though you knew her briefly, she saw a lifetime of love and happiness with you. Now we are living it, and I promise to keep living it with you, for you and for the family we will become. With this ring, I do thee wed.
Parker Francis, here we are, you and me, taking this next phase, stage, chapter, or however other people want to call it. To me, though, this is another day of falling in love with you even more. That almost seems impossible, knowing that I have loved you for 6 years, and that I get to keep doing so for the rest of our lives. Clichés are cliché for a reason, and one of them that I'd always hear is that no relationship is perfect. The thing that I've always known but somehow struggled to accept is that there's no such thing as perfect. What brings you and I here today is not about how things have gone right, how things could have been better, or how there were things that did go wrong. To me, none of that matters. What makes ours so separate, unique, and different from the others is that it's simply you and me, Parker and Renee, and in a few minutes, Mr. and Mrs. Francis. You've taught me to love without fear, and the only time I'd experience fear would be a concept of a life without you. In it, I love that you're also my best friend, because before you, I thought friendship was separate from romance. I love how you think of me, even in the smallest of ways, like replacing my recently lost eyelash curl. I love how I can just be my genuine, authentic self. Parts of me that no one else but you gets to see. You know me, Parker, an anxious woman through and through. But one of the few things in my life that I'm so sure of is this moment with you right here, right now. I vow to fiercely love you always. I know you don't like when I get cheesy, but secretly I know you love it because you love me. And I love you more than the anti-monitor.
I'm a mess right now.
It's okay. This ring, I want you. But this ring, I want you.
I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride. I'd like us to just take a moment of silence for members of Parker's family who are not with us today, but are with us in heart and in memory. May we have a moment of silence. Together. We're going to blow out the little flames and let one flame for both families join together forever in unity. Continue on. First time to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Parker and Renee Francis.
Tell you to go fuck yourself. Miami. Give them a big round of applause.
Congratulations and best wishes to both of you. May God bless you and guide you on your journey.
Well, I'm not good at public speaking. I think Parker picked me just so you can have a little laugh at his name. But I've known Parker for roughly 14 years, from when we were causing trouble in middle school, where teachers were splitting us up because we caused trouble for all the other kids in the class. And to the point where they would call us bickering with ladies, because we'd sit in the back room bickering all class. And over those 14 years, I've seen Parker grow, pull down a couple times, and continue to grow. And I'm stunned by how far we have come from when we were kids to now. You know, you've gone through a lot, and I know that as time goes on, you'll keep growing. And even with all the hardship I went through, you were always there for me. No matter what it was, if it was pushing me to go out somewhere, if it was dragging me out of my person, coming to my house, getting in the house, and dragging me. Parker does not really take no for an answer. It's either I go out because I want to, or I go because I don't want to. But you've been there for me, and I appreciate you more than anyone that I've ever known. And Renee,
it's okay.
You know, when you came to Parker's life, he was going through a lot. And, you know, I'm very happy that you were able to come in and bring that light to help him shine even brighter than you already was. Parker is always pushing himself to succeed. Always worried about what other people fall down. You know, he's always been very hard on himself, harder than everyone else usually is. And he's always thinks that he's doing the wrong. You know, he's always looking for someone else to say, yeah, you're doing good. And I want you to know you never have to look for that from someone else, because you've always been doing good. Sorry, that keeps cutting out. But, you know, you never have to look outside. You always have to look inward. And you've always grown, no matter if you doubt yourself or not. You've always grown more and more. As life went on, you'll continue to grow more and more as life goes on. But now, you have someone to grow with. And hopefully she keeps you in the reins. You know, you get a little crazy sometimes. Yeah.
She's good at her job,
sorry. Yeah. But, I love you both, you guys. I'm very happy to be here. I'm very happy to have this special part here in your wedding. And Parker, I know home and your mom would have loved to be here. They would have loved the ceremony. They would have loved everything about it. And even if they're not here physically, they're here. They're watching both of you, and they'll always be. Right? I love you, brother.
I love you, too.
I love you, Renee.
I love you, too, Brian.
And...
He's done.
So, just like Brandon, I know Parker picked me to come out here because I hate public speaking.
Yes, there is!
So, I don't know how I'm going to follow up with the past two speeches. Like, they did a phenomenal job. I'm getting, like, a complete dumbass in comparison. But, I've known Parker since we were basically in elementary school. We're, like, 3 years apart, and I've always been, like, an older brother to him. He's told me multiple times. With Parker, it's never a dull day in my life. Like, this boy would come on over every morning as early as 5 o'clock, just so we could play some video games before school. He would, I could already see my mom reacting to this. He would scout out the window to see when she left. And as soon as she left, this boy would come down the steps with a double bag, give you controllers and games, so we can have some fun before school. And we also did that after school as well. Me, Parker, and Jason, my brother, we would take turns looking out the window seeing when she would come. There was one moment where she got home way too early than she was supposed to, And we got everything put away. We were trying to, you know, make sure there was nothing that wasn't supposed to be out. Yeah. But Parker could not make it out the door in time. So what we did is we took him and basically threw him between the wall and the bed. He was just tucking. An hour goes by. And I know this boy is like hungry, so I'm like, you know what, let me get him a little snack. I guess my mom to take me to the lower library because I told her I was going to do some research projects. I asked my mom sometimes if I could get out of the hole. But there's like another time where this boy, like, I don't know what he was thinking, but for some reason he thought that it'd be funny to take some iced tea powder and line it up so he can snort it through a straw. And I'm telling you, it's never a dull moment with this guy. It's always something fun or just like, why did you even bother doing that? It was crazy. I want to ask the guys in this room, do you ever feel like Parker is a little extra? And by that I mean, he comes on to you in a very homosexual way. In front of me. Parker, I love you so very much. And I know I'm not really open to my feelings, my emotions. I kind of just bottle them up. Like, I just hide them. But you're my brother. You're my best friend. I love you so much. Renee, I am sure you're the reason why he changed his ways.
I know you keep him in check. He says something, I'm like, I know you give him a little. I do believe that you guys are perfect for each other, and that I'm just so glad that you guys finally tied the knot.
Yeah, so true. No. I was kidding.
Honestly, I was wondering when it was going to happen.
I was kidding.
Listen. I just want to wish you guys a very long and happy life together. Just cherish each second that you have with one another. Just never let go of each other. That's all I got to say. I love you both very much.
Love you, Ed.
That's it. I am so, so, so happy for you. You have been my best friend since I was a kid, and to watch you grow, prosper, and thrive, and be the woman that you are today, it's making me so happy and proud, and you are such a light, joy, and inspiration in my life, and you would always be a second mother figure and a constant source of inspiration and happiness for me. And Parker, I met you, I think it was 2017?
Yeah.
2017 Thanksgiving dinner? So that was
6 years ago?
Yeah.
Okay, so 6 years ago, I don't know, from the first impressions, from seeing you guys together, to being here today, I just need to tell you guys are honestly, like, meant to be. I have never met someone so infatuated, so in love, my sister, and from an outside perspective, you showed me and teach me what love should look like, and for that, I'm forever grateful. From you coming over constantly to every Thanksgiving dinner, to some Christmas dinners, to then going to the Philippines with us, meeting Renee's family, just means so much to me, and to have and grow a relationship with you as a brother, I'm so grateful to have you in my life. And I'm sure my family is very grateful to have you in my life, and I'm so excited to get closer and know everybody in your family. And yeah, so in this celebration of love Everybody, pick up your champagne glasses. Don't be shy.
Yes.
And let's make a toast to Renee and Margaret Francis for the celebration of love.
See, I see when you're